An update on another big weather story that could have a big impact on forecasting hurricanes.
Yeah, over the weekend, we told you the Defense Department would stop sharing certain satellite data with NOAA and NASA. Originally, it was set to happen by the end of June, but that has now been delayed by about a month.
First Warning Meteorologist, Chief Meteorologist Tony Manolfi joins us now to explain why this data is so critical to forecasters, Tony.
So, you know, you guys know this. We have all different types of satellites and radars that we use, and one of the pieces of information that we like to use is a special type of satellite. This is what you're used to seeing every day, folks, but there's a different type of satellite imagery called the Special Sensor Microwave Image Sounder. Now, that's important because, think about it, the best analogy I can make for you is when you go in, you got a broken bone, you get an x-ray. This is the x-ray that we use for satellite imagery to kind of determine what's going to be going on within a storm, especially those that are near our coast, like up in the Panhandle or off the east coast of Central Florida. It basically helps us understand the storm structure. It assists in predicting the potential for rapid intensification. And if the Department of Defense cuts that, we lose a very, very valuable tool. And that's the real concern here going forward, because it helps us during the day. It helps us at night when hurricane hunters aren't flying. So it's an extra blanket of protection. It helps us to see what's going on internally within a storm, whether it's going to be rapidly intensifying. Is lightning on the increase? Are the storm tops increasing? This particular type of imagery is the imagery that is so, so valuable and can save many, many lives. If this goes away in July, the end of July, then we're going to have a big problem. Now, the thinking is that there's going to be more pushback from NOAA and NASA, and then that could push it back into the end of hurricane season. Let's hope, Nancy and Stu, that that's indeed the case.